Okay, how about the quiz? When we should have quiz? Next week?
Sir, next week during class time, not the weekend.
No, during the weekend. I have to take the quiz during weekend. How about Thursday? Thursday, do you have any problem?
Thursday, sir.
No,
Thursday,
sir.
sir.
Sir, Thursday, I have an afternoon class.
From when to
Data
when?
mining.
From when?
6:30 to 9:30. She's the
So
third class.
we're going to place the quiz on 3 to 5 or 3 to 4.
Oh.
All right, so let's start.
Sir, next week it Thursday pe na ki ek week Thursday pe.
Next week. Okay, so let's start. Classification of data. According to Chomsky. Chomsky is a very famous linguist and computer scientist. Grammar can be of four types. Number one, type three, type two, type one, type zero. Type 3 grammar is also known as regular grammar. Type 2 grammar is also called known as context-free grammar. Type 1 grammar is also known as context-sensitive grammar. Type 0 is grammar known as unrestricted grammar. So far, all the grammar examples we have seen, those are regular grammar. Why those are regular grammar? Can you tell me? All the grammar examples we have shown so far, all are type 3 or regular grammar. Why those are regular grammar?
So we can find the regex of those.
Wonderful, fantastic, because we can find regex. That means actually that is nothing but regular language, and regular language representing regular grammar. But Noam Chomsky, his full name is Noam Chomsky. Noam Chomsky formally defined the type 3 of regular grammar. According to him, type 3 or regular grammar can be represented this way. Each product is the form A derives B alpha or beta. Okay? Each product is the form A derives B alpha or beta. Where A comma B belongs to variable alpha comma beta belongs to terminal star. Did you get that definition? Is there any question about definition? Now tell me, how about this? A derives B A or A, B derives nothing but A. Is this regular or not? Is this grammar regular or not? Yes, no. What are the variables here? So,
capital A and B.
In type 3 grammar, left side there is one variable, right side there will be only one variable. And that would be on the leftmost position or the rightmost position. And terminal can be anything. So is this regular or not?
Yes, sir, regular.
Left side, there is only one variable. Right side, leftmost position, there is one variable. And terminal, there is no bound. So definitely this grammar is regular. How about this? A derives B, A, or A? B derives A, A, A. Is this grammar regular or not?
Yes, sir, regular.
Yes, sir.
There is left side, only one variable. Right side, there is only one variable on the leftmost position. Terminal can be anything. And if there is terminal, no problem. Beta here, one variable, there is terminal. So this grammar is also there. How about this? A derives B, B, A, A, or A. B derives A. Is this grammar regular or not?
No, sir. Two variables on the right.
There are two variables there. Double variable. So this grammar is not regular. All right, you understand. Now, regular grammar can be divided to two ways. Regular grammar can be divided to two broad categories. One is called left linear grammar. Another one is called right linear. What is the difference? Here, the variable on RHS on the leftmost position. And the variable in here on RHS on the So here, is this left linear grammar or right linear grammar? Go to right hand side. So this is the right hand side. The variable is on the leftmost position. So it is left linear grammar, LLG. Here also, the variable is on the leftmost position. So it is LLG. How about this? A derives B or A. B derives A, A, A. Is this regular grammar?
Yes, sir, regular.
Right hand side, there is only one variable, no bound on the terminal. So this is definitely regular grammar. But here the variable is the rightmost position. So
yes, sir.
RLG. So this definition has two parts. This or A derives alpha, B, or beta, where A comma B, so know the difference. This is B, this is beta. Variable alpha comma beta belongs to test. And this one is called right linear grammar. This one is called left linear. So did you understand? Now, if you really understand, how about this? Let's take this example. A derives B, A, or A. B is nothing but B, A, A, or A, A. Is this regular grammar?
Yes, sir.
On the right hand side, there is only one variable, leftmost position. Yes. And also in this product, right hand side, that is only one variable. It is on the leftmost position, and left hand side has only one variable. So this is definitely regular grammar. What type of grammar is this?
Left linear grammar.
But if you intermix left linear grammar with right linear grammar, then it is not regular grammar. That means if you write this way, A derives B A A, B is nothing but A A B. Or AA, then this is not regular grammar because here intermixed LLG with RLG. So that is the problem.
Sorry, I think combined gra, left linear
combined grammar. If there is a combined of left linear grammar and right linear grammar, then it cannot be regular grammar. It will become something else. So combination is not possible. Okay. Okay. So far, all the grammars we have studied, they are actually regular grammar because they have regular expression in one hand, and all they are falling in these categories. If you've gone through all the grammars, you are going to see all the products is the either form of A derives B alpha or beta, or A derives alpha B or beta. Now, we already know that regular grammar, regular language has a acceptor, which is nothing but finite automata, and we also have pointed out regular grammar has a generator, which is called regular grammar, and it has a representation regex. In fact, we have proved each regular language has a finite automata, and we also prove finite automata means a regular language. We have also proved regular expression as a regular language, and regular language as a regular expression. So we have already done with this part. How about this? If we have given a finite automata, if we can convert it to regular grammar, or if we have given a regular grammar, if we convert it to finite automata, then this trilogy, not trilogy, there are four people, four musketeers, so they are getting equivalent. So right now we are trying to prove that. So how can we convert a regular grammar to finite automata and finite automata to regular?
To regular language.
Through regular language, it is difficult because language is infinite. Language might be infinite, but finite automata and regular grammar, they are actually finite representation. So it is better to convert regular grammar to finite automata or finite automata to regular grammar. But eventually then it will prove that everything is our equivalent. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Because we know that finite automata means there is equivalent regular language, and regular language means there is equivalent finite automata. So it is better to just convert this. If we somehow convert this, automatically it becomes regular grammar is equivalent to finite automata, and finite automata is equivalent to regular language. Then eventually regular language also equivalent to regular grammar, and regular grammar equivalent to regular language. So we are going to do different. So how can you convert a regular grammar to, let's do this one first. How can you convert a finite automata to regular grammar? So finite automata to regular grammar. So give me a finite automata. Let's try this. Start with very simple one. Okay. This is my finite automata. Let's name this stage. Let's call it A. Let's call it B. So how can you convert? This is the start state. So this would be my A. Start variable also.
Yes.
So A can derives to
going to
A B. So A B, can derives to small a capital A. This is the okay, first product. Then
so sorry. Can
yes, tell me.
My sir, এখানে কি কনকেটের মতো ইউজ করছেন নাকি? কনকেটের মতো স্যার এ
কনকেটের kind of but if you reach this state, then from this state you reading a you can reach to b. So a is nothing but a can be represented as small a b. Now what is b? B is nothing but a b. B, if you reach to B,
then again
A,
B.
A, B, or you can go to B, B. So this is the graph.
Sir, তাহলে কি স্যার এটা অলওয়েজ রাইট লিনিয়ার গ্রামারই হবে
আসছে আসছে হ্যাঁ আসছে সরাসরি লেফট লিনিয়ার গ্রামার করা যায় সরাসরি লেফট লিনিয়ার গ্রামার করা যায় বাট আমরা এটা করব না আমরা একটু অন্যভাবে করব কন্ট্রোল তো দিস ইজ দা কেস সো দিস ইজ দা কারেক্ট রেগুলার গ্রামার নাও ইউ মাইট সে স্যার ক্যান ইউ প্রুভ দ্যাট দিস ইজ দা রেগুলার হোয়াট ইজ দা রেগেক্স ফর দিস হোয়াট ইজ দা ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ starts with it. What is the language? What is the string inside this? A, A B, A A, so on. What is the regex? A.
Sir, A contains A union B minister.
Yes, minister. Yes, now see, how can I generate? Okay, another last thing. So, start state is A. So, A is the start variable. B is the final state. So, we have to close this B. So, we are going to put here epsilon. Final state, we have to put epsilon. Now, this is the conversion technique. Now, see, how can I generate A? A derives AB, B derives epsilon. Colors. If we want to go to
N, A union B can be
B. Wait, from this grammar, if I want to N, I have to go to B. And when I want to go to B, I have to prefix A. So it always starts with A. Did you get it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the case. Do you have any question you can ask me? Any question?
Sir, final state is always epsilon, but
that's correct. Right?
Final state is also epsilon. The top. If you don't put final state epsilon, then there is a problem because then recursion would not end. All right. Any query? Any query you can ask me, okay?
No, sir.
So let's take another answer. How about this? What would be the grammar? A is the start state, so A is the start variable. A, from A, reading A, you can reach to B. So A can derive to A, B. Now, what is B? B can, if you go to B, seeing another A, seeing another A, you can remain in
A.
Or reading a B, you can go to A. Now, what is the final state? A. So put a epsilon. Now, what is the language accepted by this final protocol? What is the regex? What is the regex? A. A star,
sir. A minister.
A star, B, then.
Then whole minister.
So this is the regex. Now tell me a string inside this language. Tell me a string. A B. I take this once. So A S to B, then S to becomes there. So how can I generate this string using this grammar? A derives, A B, B derives, B derives, A B, then B derives,
our B
A, then finally this A derives epsilon.
Epsilon.
How can you generate epsilon? The epsilon is inside the string, so A directly derives to epsilon. Anything else? How about this? A, B. I can generate this. I take A star B, then A star is replaced to 2A. How can I generate this? A derives A, B. Finally, this one derives
BA,
and epsilon. So this, what would be the yield? In this case, yield is A, B. In this case, A, B. Okay. So this is the, this is how we can represent the finite automata to grammar. So it seems grammar is more powerful. Any finite automata can be represented by regular grammar. But if I can do the reverse one, regular grammar, if we can convert it to finite automata, then we are done. Okay, so this is easy. Now let's do the reverse one.
আমি লেফটের জন্য রাইটে আউটপুট করতেছি আর রাইটের জন্য লেফটে ইয়ে করতেছি স্যার ওইটা হচ্ছে যে স্যার
কোশ্চেন ইজ নট ক্লিয়ার টু মি ক্যান ইউ এক্সপ্লেইন দ্য কোশ্চেন
স্যার আমি মিল খুঁজতে স্যার বহুত বলতে গেলে যে রাইটের জন্য আমি লেফটে গেলে দেন আমি আউটপুটের সিকোয়েন্স গুলো পাচ্ছি আর কি হ্যাঁ
রাইটের জন্য লেফটে গেলে আউটপুটে সিগন্যাল পাচ্ছি হ্যাঁ মানে
আচ্ছা ট্রিপ হইছে
গিভ এ কনক্রিট এক্সাম্পল Give me a string.
Sir. So, is
can anybody explain the question to me?
So, Mata, some question. What do you have to say?
Think. Whenever you are getting clear, ask me the question.
Okay, sir.
Now, how can you convert regular grammar to final grammar? Let's take a regular one. A derives. B derives. C derives. C or C. This is a regular grammar. So how can I convert this regular grammar to finite automata? How can I convert this regular grammar to finite automata? Very simple. This is the start variable. So this is my state A. Let's give another one. This is my state B. This is my state C. Okay. Now, starting from here, as it is the start variable, this is the start state. From A, seeing A, you are coming back to A. So there is a self loop. Seeing A, you can go to B. So A to B. B. What? So A to B means you are in the final state. So B, you are going to a final state. Now B, seeing B, you should remain in B. B, seeing B, can go to C as well. B, C. Then C, seeing C, it should remain in C, or C, it going to final state. This is my final state. Did you get the point?
স্যার এখানে স্যার রেগুলার গ্রামারে এপসাইলন থাকে না স্যার ফাইনান্স
এপসাইলন থাকলে এপসাইলন থাকলে সেটা সেভাবে হ্যান্ডেল করব আরেকটা एग्जांपल দেব ডোন্ট ওয়ারি এপসাইলন যদি থাকে আমরা एग्जांपल দেব ডোন্ট ওয়ারি এখানে তো এপসাইলন নেই গ্রামারটা রেগুলার গ্রামারে এপসাইলন থাকতে হবে এরকম কোনো কথা নেই এটা তো টি স্টার না এটা তো টি স্টার আম আই রাইট উই আর সাদমান
জি স্যার
টি স্টার এপসাইলন মাইট বি देयर মাইট নট বি देयर ফর্মটা ঠিক থাকলে হবে বাট এপসাইলন থাকলে কি করব উই গোইং টু গিভ আ আনসার ডোন্ট কাম সো লেটস গিভ মি আ স্ট্রিং হুইচ ইজ ইনসাইড দিস রেগুলার গ্রামার হুইচ ক্যান বি জেনারেটেড বাই দিস রেগুলার গ্রামার হাউ অ্যাবাউট দিস A derives AA, A derives AB, B derives BC, C derives CC, finally C derives C. So what is the yield? AA, B, C, C. AA, B, C, C. So this string can be generated by this grammar. So how can I accept this? See, A. Then A, A, so I'm going from A to A, sing A, then A to B, sing A, then B to C, sing B, then C to C, sing C, finally C to F, sing another C. Did you get the point?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, where something was if say if there is epsilon no, what can you do? Let's take a grammar. A derives A, A B, or epsilon. So how many states would be there? A, B, C. A is the start variable, so it would be the start state. A sorry, if you are in state A, seeing A, you can be in the state A. So A can be derived to A small a capital A. Then A can also derive to small a capital B. Like this. Or epsilon. So it means it is the final state. Then B seeing B can remain to here. B sing B can go to C as well. Now C, sing C can remain to C, and C, it can be stopped, so it can go to final state. So I'm going to have done. This is the catch. Did you get the point?
Yes, sir.
So give me a string which is inside this grammar. You can make it more complicated also. You can create an extra, it is also possible. You create an extra final state, then giving epsilon move here and joining C over here. It is also possible, but that seems extra to me. It is not necessary. Okay. That way you can do. Now give me a string which is inside this grammar.
A, A, B, B, C, A.
A A B B C A. A A B B C A. A A B B C A. A A B B C A.
But sir, तो A होने का नक्शे A तो हमारे sir.
ना wait wait ये तो generate करते पारेगी ना grammar का शेटा के देखता हूँ. क्यों भाई तो आपने generate कर में ना grammar के देखने देखी. A can derive to. You have to derive it to A. Fine. That's what you call it. Again, this A should be AB. AB or A?
AB.
AB, okay.
So it's more like
then B is going to derive to BB. There is no other option.
BB.
And this one should derive to?
Again BB.
BC. C.
Good. Very good. Then? Then what? Then what? Then?
Sir.
This B is going to derive to? B can derive to? CC. But for C, take A derive permanent. C take A derive permanent. This C take A derive permanent. C থেকে A derive করবেন কিভাবে বলেন আমার মনে হয় আসলে আপনারা এটার জন্য কনফিউজ হয়ে যাচ্ছেন ঠিক আছে আমরা একটা রুলস দিচ্ছি আসলে ইফ আই নট রুলস দ্যাট ইজ স্ট্রেট কারণ A A B B C C A দ্যাট ইজ আ প্রবলেম সো দিস ফরগেট অ্যাবাউট দিস ডোন্ট ডু দিস ওয়ে ইয়েস ইট ইজ নট গুড There's a problem. It is better to create a new final state and join with this. It is better. Then apni eta generate korte parben. Tale apni parben. A, A, B, B, C, then you cannot. So this is better. This one is better. So do this way. Ota korle aro bipod. Ebar thik ache. Tar mane eta generate kora jabe na. এটা জেনারেট করা যাবে না এ জেনারেট করা যাবে তাহলে এটা দেখেন কিভাবে জেনারেট করি এ এ বি বি সি সি এ টু এ সিং এ দ্যাট এ টু বি সিং অ্যানাদার এ দ্যাট বি টু বি সিং বি দ্যাট বি টু বি গোইং টু সি দেন দেন ওয়াট সি টু এফ সিং সি দিস ইজ দ্য ফাইনাল ওকে গাইস অলরাইট থ্যাংক ইউ এটা আরো প্রবলেম ক্রিয়েট করে Some books they do that way, but that is a great problem. I'll take a code example. Should I do another example? So let's do another example. A derives A or A B or A. B derives B B or B C or F seven. C derives C C or C. How many states are there? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. A B C. Then what? A sing A should go here. A sing A should go B. And A should A, it should terminate. So this would be final state. B sing B should remain B. B sing B should go to C. Or epsilon. So it is going to terminate. C sing C should remain C. Or sing C it should terminate. So So this is the final. All right, guys, give me a string inside this one. How about this? AB. So how can you accept AB? How can you accept AB? This is inside this grammar because A can derive.
Sure.
A can derive. A can derive AB. A can derive AB, then B can derive BB, then B can derive F7. So what is the yield? A, B. So how can you do that? Yes, starting from A, seeing A, I'm going to B. Seeing B, I will remain in B. Finally, B to I'm going to F7, final state, seeing F7. Okay, guys? So that is the answer. Do you have any question you can ask me? any question? Acha. So far, already Vya Sardhan Vasil asked the question. Yes, sir. All the grammars you are writing this way, they are actually right linear grammar. So is it possible to convert them to right linear grammar? To left linear grammar? Yes, it is possible. So we are going to study that technique now. So all those grammars are right linear grammar. But from this, we have proven one thing, that any finite automata is equivalent to regular grammar, and any regular grammar is equivalent to finite. So they are equal in power. So we have done QED. Okay, done. Now, conversion from right linear grammar to left linear grammar. So let's take a right linear grammar. A derives A or A B. B derives BB or B. This is my grammar. So how can I convert this right linear grammar to left linear grammar? Tell me. Any idea? If you just write this way, A derives capital A small a or capital B small a, B derives capital B small b or B. This is a left linear grammar, true. But are they accepted in the same language?
Reverse language.
Reverse language. Karan, ekhane jodi accept kore, for example, if you accept here A, B, then what happened? You are reading from here to here, from left to right. But when you flip, it is reading actually B to A. So it is accepting Ba. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And I'm a pura take flip kore this. Shab kichu flip kore diyeche. So there's a problem. So this, if it is accepting language L, it is accepting language R. So that's the problem. So what can you do? Problem. So one thing we can do, we already know the tricks. Actually, there is a more shortcut way to do this thing, but I'm not going to show you because I have somehow invented that trick. But I'm not sure, quite sure right now, is it correct or not? So far it is correct, but eventually if it is correct, I'm going to publish a paper, most probably. Then I'm going to publish, I'm going to show you. The thing is, there's a problem. So it is actually reversing the language. So what can we do? If there is a right linear grammar, which is accept the language, we convert it to finite automata. Am I right? We know the technique. Conversion.
Yes, sir.
Then what is the language accepted by finite automata? The same language. Then what we are going to do? We are going to reverse this finite automata. So it is finite automata 1. This is finite automata 2. What is the language accepted by this?
L reverse.
So this is a final state.
Good. Tarpor, I'm going to convert this finite automata to RLG. Again, another RLG. This is RLG 1, it is RLG 2. What is the language accepted by this RLG? Language reverse. Then I'm going to reverse this grammar. Then what do I get? I get a linear grammar, but in this normal case, LR again flipped, so it would become L. So this is the technique. Wonderful, but very costly technique. Very costly technique. So let's try to conduct this. The first thing is, what is my grammar? My grammar is A derives A capital A capital B, B derives small b capital B or B. So what is the final automata for this? It is accept. Well, in step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we are in step 1. Now, what is the final automata for this? How many states would be there? A, B. A, B, this is the start state. This is the start state. Then what? S in A, it should go in here. S in A, it should go in B. Then?
B, same state.
Same state. Then B, seeing B, going to final state.
Final state.
So this is the 2. What is the language accepted with this? L? This is also L. Now, what is the third state? This is the final element. This should become start state. And this will become final state. So this is the step number 3. It is accepting language reverse. Right? Then what is the fourth step? Writing a light linear grammar for this. So we know that. It would be nothing but if B, then B. If the borrow author if the Archajayokshamashana. B derives.
Sir, B. B manager
or
B
A.
That's A.
And A derives. A derives. And A is the final state, so that is the epsilon. So we got number 4. And what is the language accepted by this? Language reverse. Now let's go to fifth steps. What is the fifth step? Just flip. So F derives BB. B derives BB or AA, A derives AA or epsilon. So let's just rewrite this language reverse language. So just make it S, BB, B derives BB or AA, A derives AA or epsilon. F is replaced by S. Now this is the final one. So can we verify what is the string inside this language? AAB. Can I derive AAB using this? Let's try. AAB. By the way, what is the actually language accepted by this grammar? Tell me. Can you tell me the regex? What is the regex for this? What is the regex for this grammar?
Your A plane square?
Nah. Final automata ta khyal karan. Eta hocche amar final automata. So what would be the language accepted by this? Simple. Start with A union B start and with B. Start with A and with B. This is the grammar. So let's take this AAB. How can I generate AAB using this? S derives BB. Then B derives
B
derives AA. Then A derives AA. Finally, this A derives F7. So what is the yield? What is the yield of this grammar? AAB. Did you get it? This don't make silly mistakes, then it will become problematic. Okay. If you straightforwardly follow my techniques, then it will be easy. But if you don't straightforwardly use my techniques, then it will become difficult. And there are some problems in internet tutorials. There are a few problems. There are many good tutorials, but there are some people make mistakes in these cases. So please remember. Okay? I'm also gone through a lot of internet tutorials, but there are some mistakes as well. There. Many good qualities, but tiny mistakes. Okay. Done? Should I do another one? Should I do another one?
Yes.
এটা রেগেক্সটা একটু একটু ভুল করেছি রেগেক্সটা এরকম হবে রেগেক্সটা হবে এ পজিশন ইজ ইম্পর্টেন্ট এ স্টার্ট দেন বি স্টার্ট দেন বি দিস উইল বি দ্য রেগেক্স এটা হবে এ ইউনিয়ন বি বিকজ আফটার আফটার জেনারেটিং এ আই ক্যান নট জেনারেট বি হোয়েন আই এম গোইং টু বি আই হ্যাভ টু জেনারেট অন দ্য বি সো এ এ ক্লাস্টার বি স্টার বি দিস উইল বি দ্য
রেগেক্স
Yes, that was the answer. Now let's go to here. How about this? Converting back linear grammar. So something like this. So let's say A derives. A. This is my right wing diagram. Okay. How can I convert this? So, step number one, accepting language one. So, number two, converting to finite automata. So, three states A, B, C, A, C, A. As a final state, then
so let's do capital F.
Promotional B C A B C A C C C C F C. So this is the language, etc. Now, number three is reverse code. Okay? Language R. Now, my question if one way is going to summon B, A. A is my initial start state, so it will be final state. And also, F can directly go to A, C, A. And that is the self. This is my reverse final component. Then, what is the next step? Convert this one to, convert this to right linear one. So, F derives. F derives
A capital A.
A capital C. A or C. And C derives.
C derives.
B. Then
B accessor B A.
Small a b or b a. Small b a.
A derives.
Small a.
A. Anything else? No. So there is no problem. So remember.
Last step.
Absolute. Oh yeah. Final step. Good. Final thank you. It's the final step. So remember, A directly derives to B. It is also a linear grammar because you can consider that as absolute. Okay. So no problem with this. Now we get the number four step. Now fifth step. F derives, so let's call it S. S derives AA or C. C derives CC or BB. B derives BA or AB. A derives AA or epsilon. So this is the function. So let's take a string which is inside this. Let's take a string which is inside this. How about this? AA, AA, B, B, C. AA, B, B, C. Can we generate this? A derives AA. This A derives AA. This one derives BB. This B derives BC. Finally, this C derives small c, capital C. This one derives as well. So what is the yield? The yield is AA, B, B, C. How can I generate this? Is it possible? S derives directly to C. Then C derives capital C, small c. Then this C derives capital B, small b. Then this B derives capital A, B. This A derives capital A, small a. Capital A, finally this one is absent. So what is the yield? A, B, B, C. Did you get it?
Yes, sir.
This is the answer. So we are done with this conversion technique. Now let's go to type 2. Let's go to type 2. So the definition, type 2 grammar is also called context-free grammar. What is the definition of type 2 grammar? According to Noam Chomsky, it is something like this. A derives alpha, where A belongs to variable, alpha belongs to variable comma terminal star. That is the problem. A belongs to V, alpha belongs to any repetition of, who is that? Sorry, alpha is any repetition of variable and terminal star. Can you wait a little bit? So this is the thing. There's a difference. In type 1, there will be terminal or a variable following with any number of terminal. Or if you are in right recursive grammar, right linear grammar, a variable on the left hand side and on the right hand side, any number of terminal or any number of terminal followed with only one single variable. But here there is no bound on number of variables on the right hand side. Did you get it?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the relation between type 3 and type 2? Let's assume like this. A derives A or A. Is it type 3?
Type 3, sir.
It is type 3. Good. Can I generate using this rule, this grammar as well? Yes, we can. A is a variable, so it is a variable. And AA, this also belongs to variable comma terminal star. Do you agree with me or not?
So type 3 is inside type
2. Yes, good. So that is my point. Capital A, small a can be also generated with variable comma terminal star. And variable, this one also can be generated with variable comma terminal star because it's a star. I can either put variable or terminal any number of times. So type 3 is a subset, not equal, subset of type 2. So that means regular grammar is a subset of, proper subset of context-free grammar. Because there are grammars which are context-free but not regular. Okay, so now let's, you might say, sir, why we need actually context-free grammar? But why do we need the Chomsky hierarchy? Are not regular grammar enough to generate anything? No. Because there is an equivalence between grammar and automata, as we cannot do everything using finite automata. We have to create more powerful machine. The same reason we have to go hierarchy of the grammar as well. For example, let's take this language. Sigma equal to A comma B. Sigma equal to A comma B. My language is A and B and greater equal to 1. Can you come up with a regular grammar for this? No, it is not possible. We know that it is not possible. We have already used pumping lemma and we have seen that this grammar is not regular language. So definitely there is no regular grammar. Because we have already proven regular grammar as equivalence with finite automata, and finite automata is equivalence with regular language. So there is no regular grammar for this. But there is a context-free grammar or type 2 grammar for this. See this technique. So what is the string inside this? Give me a string inside this.
A, B, B.
So A, B, then A, B, B, then A, and B, B. So it is nothing but we are generating number of A, then we are generating, first we are generating number of A, then we are generating number of B. Position is important, number is also important. So I can write a grammar like this. So how can I write the grammar? When I generate this A, I'm going to generate this B. When I generate this A, I'm going to generate this B. When I generate this A, I'm going to generate this B. What can I do? SD writes, when I generate A, I generate a B. In the middle part, we're generating rest. So what happened? Initially generates A, B. Then it is recursive S, again generate A, B. Finally, when I want to stop, I stop with A. So we can generate this. Did you get it?
Push down, sir, stack and motor.
Wait, push the, yes, stack like, yes. But the thing is, it is not regular grammar. Why? Because it is not left linear or right linear. We have this variables in the middle, which breaks the type 3 definition. So let's try some languages. How about this? AM, BM. M comma N greater equal to 1. Does we have regular grammar for this?
Yes, sir.
We have. Because here actually M and N does not have any relation. We do not need to remember how many A's we are generating. Then we do not need to remember matching of B with that. Only thing is, the position is important. So what would be the regex for this? Regex would be A star, then B star, B. This is the regex. So definitely it has the regular grammar. So what would be the regular grammar for this? How can we generate A star? A star is nothing but A derives A or upset.
Then
B star is nothing but BB or F7. So what would be this? This would be A capital A, B capital A. This is the grammar. Okay, now let's come back to here. L equal to A and B and CM. m comma n, it's equal to. So is it possible to generate regular grammar for this?
No, sir. C and
because
A.
Because I have to remember number of A, then I have to check with number of C. But is it possible to generate context-free grammar for this? Hopefully possible. So how can I generate any number of B? Simple. B derives, BB, or epsilon. All right. Achha, ekhane epsilon hobe na. আচ্ছা এখানে অ্যাপসাইলন হবে না, আচ্ছা জিরো করে দেন, জিরো করে দেন, তাহলে এখানে একটা মনে রাখেন, এটা এ করে দেন, বি করে দেন, যেহেতু ওয়ান আছে, আচ্ছা এটা ওয়ান আছে, তো এখানে অ্যাপসাইলন হবে না, বি হবে. সো হাউ ক্যান ইউ ডু দিস? So we are done with the middle part. Now we have to check A. So when I'm going to generate A, I'm going to generate C. Again, another A, I'm going to generate another C. So S derives A, C,
A.
C, A, C. And it's a generator. Yes, sir. What is the name of the
generator?
Our S. So initially I generate number of A and equal number of C. After generating this, I'm going to generate the middle part. So after that one, I'm going to B. So this is the grammar. Did you understand? So this is the grammar. If you give B, then you can generate only one A and C. But if you give S, we are done with number of generating A and number of C, then we are going to middle part. Did you get the point?
Sir,
Ekhane,
yes, sir. ডিরেক্ট কিন্তু স্যার স্মল বি চলে আসছে না স্যার, এস থেকে বি তে যাই স্যার.
ও সো গুড, ভেরি গুড অবজারভেশন. সো হোয়াট ডোন্ট ইউ পুট এ এন্ড সি ওভার দেন দেন ওয়ে দেন
রাইট, ওকে স্যার,
ফ্রম দেন দ্যাট ইজ সো ফর. ইয়েস, গুড, ভেরি গুড অবজারভেশন, গুড, ভেরি গুড. হাউ আর দিস? ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ ইজ A n, B m plus n, C n, m comma n, greater equal to 1. So how can you generate? Regular grammar is not possible because a to the power n you have to remember, then c to the power n, then you have to check with b m plus n. So regular grammar is not possible. Is it possible to draw context-free grammar?
Sir, we can break down, sir.
Break down, good, very good.
AN, BN so, into BN.
Yes, AN, then BN, then BM, CN. So we are going to checking AN with BN, BM with CN. Good, very good observation. So there are two parts. We have to just join these two parts. We know how to do AN, BN, and BM, CN. So how can I do this one? This one is nothing but A derives.
Small AB,
A, capital A, B, or AB. What is this? B derives B, B, C, or BC. So, star symbol is nothing but joining these two. So, this is the grammar. Very good observation. Very good observation. How about this? L equal to A, N plus M, B, M comma N, get away. Can we do this? Can we do this?
So again, try to break down, sir.
Try to break down, is that possible? Regular grammar is not possible because we have to at least. Is the regular grammar possible for this? Is the regular grammar possible for this? Tell me. Is it actually A star comma B star? No, it is not. Because if you write A star comma B star, the problem is, or A plus comma B plus, if you generate BB, there must be 3A, must be 3A. Even it can have more. But if you give this, it can also generate BB and A. So there's a problem. So it is not possible to regular grammar. But if you break this AM, AM, BM, there is no bound about this. And it is like before. So what is the building block? A, D, S, A, B, or AB. And this one is nothing but, let's say this B dash, B is nothing but BA or A. Then just join this BA. This is the grammar. All right. This is the end of today's class. If you have any questions, you can ask me questions. Otherwise, you can leave. But if you understand this problem, good problem. Any question, guys?
No, sir.
No question? So let's take your attendance, then we are going to leave it. So we are tentatively fixed our quiz date. It would be on Thursday, most probably 3 to 4. Okay, guys. If we have time clash, let me know before. Well, once I'm fixed the date, don't say this.
The next all right? week, sir.
Next week, not this week.
Which is,
and the
is
syllabus, the syllabus would be regex and the grammar. All the regex and grammar. And this week, most probably, we have a makeup class, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So take care, guys. Bye. See you then.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Bye, guys. I love you.